Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today I'm gonna paint a lake house. So I'm gonna put a house here everyone, and it will be on the lake course, and some trees and some reflections and a mountain in the back. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed it, and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see the 5 limited colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and yeah, I'm going to start with the sky, maybe something like that. Okay, there you go. So I'm going to use a bit of blue, and then red, and then white. More red. So let's start to add some bit of bluish tone on our mountain. I am still blocking everyone. I already have the sketch, and now I am trying to add under painting. If you are painting me, just follow it. Follow what I'm doing. There. And then I'll try to add a bit of darks here. Okay. I'll try now to add some sky. Blue and then white. There. I'm going to use some a little bit orange and white and then yellow. Yeah. I am going to put it here in the bottom part because I'm gonna make it like an afternoon landscape. See, the problem with putting it without cleaning the brush is that the color will mix to the existing blue color. It's okay if you cover some parts of your one. As long as you know the details there, it's fine. There. Okay, and then we can mix again a little bit. Lighter purple. I'm gonna put some white, and we can put it here. That is too bright. There. Okay. And then I have here the red and the blue. And again, another purple, everyone. It's a bit light purple, or maybe a little bit of bluish purple. Okay. Let's make it a bit lighter. Actually, you can use a smaller brush. There. Okay. There you go. Yeah, and then I'll try to start now adding the reflection. Just drag it down like that, everyone. There. Yeah, same color, and like that. And then make another bit lighter on the farther part. There. And then I will try to use this raw amber and the blue. Yeah, I will try to add a reflection like that color here. And then I will try a bit of bluish purple and then a little bit of amber. And put it here on the bottom. This is a lake, everyone, so we expect that the water will be still, not moving so much, or there's no so much ripple as we can see. So yeah. There, so as you can see now, the reflection looking good, and it's even frying now. So I'll just fill everything here with the colors using medium size flat brush number 8. Yeah, I'm gonna use some raw umber. I will cover this part. Even this one, we can cover with raw umber, but the white part I will not cover. And then we can try to add some leaves on the background. So yeah, using the blue and the raw umber, I can create those beautiful trees. You can make it dark, everyone, like that. I'll just make it dark. But later on, I can put any colors. Just topping technique. There. Another one for everyone with the blue color. Just put a bit of pine trees. Okay, so here. Yeah, so as you can see, everyone, we have the pine trees on the back, something like that. And even here. then you can try some red and then yellow. There, you can try to put also there. I think a little bit more amber because this is too much brown. Adding brown, everyone, it makes it look good. I'll just blend those brownish tone there, like that. There, okay. So we have now this island here. Next, I'm gonna try slowly to add some clouds. Yeah, I'll use the same brush, but make sure that you're gonna clean your brush, everyone, because it's a bit dirty. So we're gonna take off all those different colors. So we're done with the underpainting here. I'll just remain white here because I want to this part to be a brighter color so that we can see it clearly. Okay, so I'm going to add a bit of clouds also. I don't want the clouds to be so strutty, everyone, but I want a little bit of brownish orange clouds. So yeah, I'm gonna try to use this, yeah, this kind, maybe a purple, reddish purple clouds, more red and then white. There, so it's like a few clouds that are making the sky a bit of looking dirty. There, I just want to make my I want to make my sky also a bit clean, everyone. So I don't want to put a lot of things there. Okay, just a bit of blendings and we are good to go. There, so I think that should be enough for my clouds. You can see that it's really an afternoon cloud. Okay, I'm going to start now adding some highlights on the mountain. So yeah, this mountain here, everyone, I'd like to put some highlights there. I will be using a smaller brush because this is just a small mountain. So I have the smallest flat brush. Here is a number 3 nylon flat brush. Can you use here the raw amber and then white? Let's add now some highlights. This will be a cliff here.
hair.
And now let's mix for greenish, blue, yellow, and then red. I'm gonna put a little bit red because I don't want that the green will become very, very colorful. Okay, this is red. It should be lighter. Always remember it's lighter. Okay, here. Just a bit of colors, everyone. Can see that the sun is hitting on this part because it's an afternoon. Always remember that the color should be always lighter, and do not use any strong colors. Add a little bit of red on the color. There, you can now see that there's a little bit greenish there, and then on the back, everyone, this mount in the back, I'm gonna put a bit of lighter. Have to show that also this part has a bit of lights there. But I will not show so much, like especially that part there. Okay. And then I will try some light purple. Try to create some trees here, something like that. There are also some trees here. There. Okay, so yeah, this part looks good. A little bit of lights, greenish, and it looks good. Okay, so I'm gonna add a little bit of white here. I really don't know what it's called, but that's what I see, that this kind of lights on the far part of the water. Okay, I'll just try to add white here, light blue color. Okay, so I'll just try to add Damn. So young. I will add an end here. And then I will also put some light like that. Okay. Leave it on the fire, everyone. You can put. So as you can see now, it looks far, yeah. And the water reflection looks so good, everyone. It's very soft. Yeah, I like the reflection. Yeah, I can still retouch the reflection later on. I will add more details there. Okay. I'll add more a lot of things that we can see in the reflection. But even this one, I like it, everyone. It looks so soft. I like how it turn out. Okay, now I'm going to add now this part here. I'm gonna try to retouch. I'm gonna try to add details with my. I'm not using my bristle brush for a long time. Where is it? Yeah, right here. My bristle brush. But I have a new bristle brush. I'll try to use it. And I don't know where I put that, but I'll just try to use this one. Okay. So, yeah, I'm gonna try to add a green, yellow, and a blue. I'll try to add red, yellow, and blue, and then some white there. Yellow there. Then tapping technique. Tapping technique. There. And also this one, everyone. Tapping technique. There, even the pointers on the back support of details, and in here we can try to add. We can also add different varieties of trees later on. Okay, so here also. There, okay, so we can see now. now I will try also a bit of different color, maybe something like an orange or brownish color. Yeah, maybe this orange is fine. Bit of orange, everyone. I'll put it here. Now let's put some tree trunk or wheat. Let's put some tree trunk, everyone. I'll be using this raw umber and the white. There. There, so we have now some trees there. Yeah, just do it slowly, everyone. Okay, so here you go. So we have now these trees, and I'll start now adding some details on the house, everyone. I want it to have a brown color in the roof, so usually a brownish color. So red, raw umber, and the yellow. I want it to become much more reddish. It's like a rusty roof, everyone. But the light is coming from the left side. I forgot to mention, everyone, that my light is coming from the left side. Usually. There. I'm gonna use a bit of red. There, so it's light there. I'll be using a smaller brush, everyone, like this. I'm gonna use some white here. It's the gutter, everyone. And then here. Yeah, I'm gonna mix for a bit of umber and in white. There. Okay. And then I will use this umber, everyone, to create darks here. Some shade. And even here, I want to create darks. There. Okay. I will also make the bottom, everyone, white. There. And here also we can put lights. There. Okay. A little bit here on the gutter part. Okay. There, okay.
So we have now something like that. We have now the house. It's good. And I'll try to add some darks here. Okay, and a bit of lights. So as you can see now, everyone, it's a rusty house. Okay, that's so good. I like that. Okay. So it's coming better now, everyone. It's looking better. I like the result. Okay, so yeah, look, using this maybe light yellowish color. I'm going to add now the trunk. And then let's start now with the run. I'm going to add a bit of darks, also shades, especially in the house. Okay, I'm gonna use this brush, everyone, the bristle flat brush. Let's add some highlights. We have here the yellow and the blue, and a bit of red. Stopping technique. There. Thank you.
Also here, everyone, you can put some highlights, just so light green, different shades of green, something like that. And then here on the top. Okay, there you go. Also here, let's put some more. Okay, there you go. Yeah, and then the other one, everyone, will be a little bit of orange. There. Okay, I'll try to use another set of brush, but I will lighten this part, everyone. Yeah, I'm gonna use this brown here, a little bit orange brown, a little bit of umber. And then I'm gonna try to add some more brighter color.
Okay. Okay. As you can see, everyone, we have now some cliff. Yeah. Cliff looking beautiful. Okay. I mean, what's called this? This, what you call it? Forget. It's actually the river bank. Okay. Or. It's a lake, everyone. I don't know what it's called. The lake. If it's a lake, maybe it has different name. Okay. So we have here the light yellow green. So slowly, I'm going to blend it, adding some greenish color. So I am using now the smallest flat brush, everyone. We have. It is the then here, let's add some lights. I'll try to add a bit of lights. Okay, and then a bit of yellow. There. Okay. Just, you know, also some lights here with the yellow green. I mean the yellow. Can do like that, everyone, so that part will become bright. And then light green and then white.
adding this one also. Okay, so I'll be using a bit of bluish tones here and red. You can put on the size which doesn't hit the lights. Okay, yeah, so good everyone. I just want to exaggerate a little bit. Okay, I'm going to add a bit of light yellow here, light orange. There. Then some yellow everyone here. And also here, put a bit of light yellow green. There. So we have now the lake house, okay? So the house beside the lake. So it looks so good, everyone. The house looks so good, the reflection is very, very nice. I am going to add a bit of details, especially on the water, okay? I have to blend a bit in the water part of one. Clean your brushes. And here, one, I will try to add a bit of that's too light, I think.
So just rub it down like that. Sorry for the noises. Yeah, just rub it down like that, everyone. Okay. Yeah. And then I'm gonna try to add a bit of lighter yellowish here, one or yeah, something like that. It should be a bit the same color on the sky. So I have here the yellow and the red, and then white, a bit of amber, yellow. There, okay, just make it dry. Okay, it's a dry brush technique now. There, so a little bit, everyone, a little bit like that color, maybe here. Just use the dry brush. Okay, so I'm gonna put some white here. And then also here. Just a bit, everyone, like that. It's just a dry brush, okay? Okay, there you go. So you have now the light there. Okay, we have now the reflection. Now reflection looks so good, everyone. It looks so smooth and simple. And then you can add a bit of white. I'll just be using this the same brush, everyone, the number 8 nylon flat brush. Is a medium size flat brush. The hair. Okay. There, okay. So with becoming much more realistic. Yeah, I like that. I like this white disturbance of water, everyone. Now I'm going to add more here, especially the reflections. I want the reflections to be darker, so I'm gonna proceed here, everyone. Okay, so I have here the raw umber and the blue, a little bit of yellow, blue and the raw umber, okay? There, okay. Also, I'm using the dry brush again. It's all just dry brush. There, okay. So I like this dark color, and now let's put some light colors also in the here, the reflection. There, so we can see now that the reflection of the house is there. Yeah, it should be, even if not perfectly accurate, everyone, but it's so, it should be like almost the same, okay? And then you should not forget also the reflection of the just drag it down like that. Yeah, to have the reflection of the of this riverbank. There, okay. So here. Okay, there you go. Even the plants, everyone, can have reflection also. There, okay, you can see now those beautiful lights, reflection of light, a little bit of brownish also here. There, that's a little bit, everyone. Here, so I to make it a bit dark. There, so looks so good and realistic, everyone. Yeah, I like that. Okay. And I'll try to retouch a bit using a smaller brush, this one. I'll try to use this one. Maybe some brownish color. Raw umber, okay.
don't know. There's amber and this greenish. There. I didn't hear everyone like that for the okay, so you can see now those figures that will make the reflection. Okay, yeah, maybe a little bit lights also on the here. Okay, so there's a clear reflection now. And I like this reflection, everyone. Then add a bit, sorry, here. To make the water clear. Okay, now it's time to add some details on the bottom part, everyone. There are some few rocks, protruding rocks, some floating leaves, something like that. I like to make it look like that, everyone. I want to make it so still that it looks like that it's very clean there, okay? Yeah, I like to do something like that. Okay. Yeah, looks so good. It's been 1 hour and 5 minutes, and so far everything looks good. Okay, so I'll try to add some rocks here. Then you can add some highlights.
And then I'm gonna try to add blue and then red and white. So just a small rock here. Yes, it will become additional to the whole work. There, okay. Yeah, and then on the other side of the run, I'm gonna try to put there some leaves there, okay? And I think it will be finished. It's just very simple and easy for this painting. Okay, so I'm gonna try to put off it. I think I will finish a bit here. Okay. There. And then I will put now some big leaves here, like that. So I'm gonna mix for green. First, darker green with the red and then yellow. There. Yeah, just a simple stroke everyone, I could create. I'm using this flat brush because I can create this beautifully. I can also use the umber. Using this one with the blue, raw umber and the blue. Make sure that your brush is flat, everyone, because you can make mistakes if it's not flat. Okay. It's a little bit hard because of this thing here. It's very... You have no space to... Raw umber and then blue. Okay. Okay, and now let's use also this small brush. There, you can also create the sleeves. Okay, now let's add the lighter greens. For now, can use a bit darker, a little bit red. Just to like that, everyone, I can create those beautiful leaves. Okay, I'm gonna add much more greenish leaves. With light yellow green. Okay, so I'm gonna put a little bit bluish lips, everyone. I'm gonna add a little bit white. Actually, lips usually normally look like this, especially like this kind of lips. Only new lips or younger lips are lighter greens. And then I can add a bit of lights. There, okay, that's good. And then let's try to add some flowers. So I like to add purple flowers, everyone. Not purple, but red. There. There, so at least this part looks so good. And now let's put some highlights. Okay, so the last part, everyone, I will try to add some, I will let you see everything first. Okay, everyone, so the next part, I'm going to add fewer details, just a little bit of light yellow green. There, or maybe here's some more umber. Okay, so I think that will be enough. And yeah, I am very happy, everyone. I hope that you are happy also. I hope that you are learning to paint this one, and can also paint your own landscape or landscape near the lake.
Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praise always belongs to the Lord.